Delete not freeing up space? Take out the trash. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Earlier this week, I was perusing the comments I got on YouTube videos and Ask Leo articles and realized that there was kind of sort of a comment or a question that popped up periodically that was simply this. I was running out of space in my email or my computer or my cloud storage. I deleted some files, and yet no space appeared to be freed up. As it turns out, the scenarios are very common and actually very easy to deal with. You just need to be aware of what's happening when you delete a file. Let's start with your disk space. When you delete a file using Windows File Explorer, that file is not deleted. Instead, it's moved from wherever the file happened to be into the recycle bin. What that means, of course, is that deleting the file doesn't free up the space because the file is still there. It's just waiting for you to change your mind, essentially, by being in the recycle bin. Eventually, it'll be deleted, but certainly not immediately. If you delete a file, or multiple files, with the expectation that you are freeing up disk space on your machine, you essentially have two options in Windows File Explorer. One is to hold down the Shift key when you do the delete. That bypasses the recycle bin. You'll probably get a warning, but the file will be deleted, actually deleted, from your system. The other approach, empty the recycle bin. So here I've got the recycle bin on this machine. You can see that it has something in it because it looks like a wastebasket with something in it. I'm going to go ahead and double click on it just so that we can see that, yeah, there's a bunch of stuff here. A bunch of stuff that's taking up space on my hard disk, even though I deleted it from its original location. So instead, what we do is we right click on the recycle bin and click on empty recycle bin. We'll get a prompt to confirm that's what we really want to do. I'm going to delete these 95 items, and poof, they're gone. Now, disk space has been freed up. What about the cloud? What if you're storing things in a cloud storage service like OneDrive? I'm going to be using OneDrive as my example, but the concepts actually apply to most of the online storage utilities like Dropbox, Google Drive, and others. So let's have a look at OneDrive. I'm going over to OneDrive.com. You can see I have files here, various things, but I also have a recycle bin. There's a theme to this video, and that is simply this. When you delete something from OneDrive using OneDrive.com, and even when you're using your PC to delete something in your OneDrive folder, in the cloud, that file is not actually deleted, but it is moved to the recycle bin. And in fact, if we look at our recycle bin, you can see that I've got a couple of files here that I recently deleted that still exist. They still take up space in my OneDrive cloud storage. If I want to get rid of them, if I want to free up this space right now, I would click on empty recycle bin. Once again, another confirmation, and the files are gone, and the space that they took up has actually been released. Normally, if you leave something in the recycle bin, it will be deleted after a certain amount of time. I think it depends on which plan you have. But if you need it gone immediately, if you're really trying to free up space in OneDrive, make sure to check the recycle bin and delete what's in it. Okay, great, OneDrive. What about email? Well, email has exactly the same issue. Email, when you delete a message from your inbox or from any other folder, that email is not actually deleted. That email is typically moved to, in this case, a deleted items folder. Now, again, this is outlook.com we're looking at online. The same concept typically applies to all of the online services like gmail.com, yahoo.com, and so forth, and your desktop email programs like Microsoft Office's Outlook, Thunderbird, and more. They may have different names. It may be deleted items, it may be trash, it may be recycle, but the bottom line here is that the concept is typically the same. When you delete an email message, it is not actually deleted, it is moved to the recycle bin or the deleted items folder. It still takes up space. So, once again, we could take a look at our deleted items. We can see that we've got a couple of them in here, and all we really need to do is click on empty folder and poof, delete all. Those emails are deleted and their space is freed up. Now, what's unique about email is that this same concept applies to spam, or as Outlook.com likes to call it, junk email. If I take a look at the junk email folder, yeah, there's a message here. It is still taking up space. It is still counting against my quota. Now, I have only one message here. Normally, you might have dozens or hundreds on my real accounts. I absolutely do. And all of those are taking up space that counts against the quota you have for that service. Same story. If you want them to really be gone, click on empty folder or whatever is its equivalent in the program or service that you're using. Now, there is one little bit of confusion that Microsoft, of course, likes to add to this mix. In Google's case, all of your email, everything in your email, and everything that you might have in Google Drive, well, it all counts against the same quota. You have online Google storage, and it's used for everything, and you have only so much of it. With Outlook.com for email, and OneDrive for files or cloud storage, the way it works is this. Attachments in Outlook.com count against your OneDrive.com storage, but email bodies do not. So that means that you can have like thousands of messages that don't have attachments, and they will have should have no impact on the amount of storage that's being reported for OneDrive. On the other hand, if you have a bunch of attachments, then those are in fact taking space from OneDrive.com in addition to whatever files you actually have stored in OneDrive. Like I said, it's confusing. One of the best ways to find out what your situation is here is in OneDrive.com down here in the lower left-hand corner. You have this option to take a look at what your storage, how it's being used. And you can see here, I've got OneDrive, I've got Outlook attachments as two different things. In my example account here, I'm not using much of anything, but you'll get a good sense of exactly how much of your storage is being used by what. Now, there are a couple of caveats that I want to throw out here. Again, just in case. One is that most cloud services will update your free space pretty quickly after you've emptied a trash or emptied a junk folder, but not all of them. Sometimes it can take a few minutes for the service to actually report back that the free space has actually been freed up and that you're now using less than you did before. So if you delete something and that number doesn't change right away, give it a few minutes. Also, for desktop email programs, when you delete something from email stored locally, and this is something that I know affects Outlook PSTs and I believe also Thunderbird mail files, that message may simply be marked as deleted, but not physically removed. You may need to run what's called a compact or some kind of update on that folder or on that PST. Normally, this happens automatically. Compaction, I know that in both Outlook, Microsoft Office Outlook, and in Thunderbird, compaction happens automatically, so that eventually, when it's worth the program's time to do so, it'll actually go through the process of compacting that file and freeing up the space. But it is something to be aware of. And finally, this has nothing to do with freeing up disk space. But because we've been talking about it so much, and I've seen people do this with disastrous results, do not rely on your recycle bin or your trash or your junk folder or your spam folder as any kind of long-term storage. If you think you might want something back, put it somewhere else. Create another folder of your own. Don't use these folders. They do get emptied automatically in some cases. Files do disappear if you leave them there long enough. And obviously, if you're looking to free up space, that's one of the first places you're going to go. Don't expect files to stay there. Hopefully now you have some ideas on different places to look, different things to do if you're struggling with disk space either on your PC or in the cloud. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/172496. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.